One day, I was cleaning the pots of the deities in the deity room. So it's our practice that we keep our small copper cups in tamarind water. So when we soak these copper cups in tamarind water, they shine so nicely. And our effort in washing them and cleaning them will be a little reduced. So the pujari who was there before me, he kept all these copper pots in the tamarind water. So all of them went bottom, touched the bottom of the vessel, and they were shining so nicely. But there is one cup that was floating on the water. So this cup is half immersed within this tamarind water, and half of the cup is above the surface of the tamarind water. So I picked up all these cups and then started washing them using soap. So this particular cup that is half immersed is not completely clean. The bottom of the cup is so shining, and the top of the cup is having a lot of spots, and it is quite blackish. So I had to put a lot of effort to scrub it and then clean it. But the real solution was to actually keep that copper cup back in the tamarind water so that it can shine like the other cups. So I have learnt a beautiful lesson from this phenomena, that whatever activity that we do, if we completely immerse ourselves in that activity and if we absorb ourselves in our activity, then we'll attain success in that activity. But if we do it half-hearted, or if you are a little distracted while doing that activity, or while doing that activity, if you always think of something or do something else, like that nowadays there is a lot of distraction due to smartphones. While we are studying something, suddenly some message comes and then it takes away 5-10 minutes of us. So if we are not distracted in whatever activity that we do, we certainly attain success in that activity. Chanchalam himana krishna pramathi balavadrudham tasyaham nigraham manye vayo rivasu dushkaram. Arjuna says, my dear Krishna, it is extremely difficult to control my mind. As a great warrior, I can easily control wind, but I cannot control the mind. So Krishna acknowledges this fact. Yes, Arjuna, it is certainly very difficult to control the mind. Asamshayam mahabaho mano durnigraham chalam abhyasena tu kaunteya vairagyena cha grihyati. Krishna says, yes, my dear Arjuna, undoubtedly it is very difficult to control the mind. But if we have little detachment, if we cultivate that little detachment from material affairs or external affairs, and if we also practice to control this mind and keep focus on our goals, then we can certainly attain success by that mind control. So Dhruva Maharaj started practicing devotional service when he was just 5 years old. But he attained success in that bhakti and attained the darshan of the Lord just within 6 months. So Dhruva Maharaj, a little boy, is giving us this grave lesson. If we focus on our practice of bhakti yoga without any deviations or distractions unnecessarily, then we can attain success by the mercy of the Lord. Thank you. Hare Krishna.